Okay, so welcome to Majesty's House of Music. So this is going to be another short free lesson. Song is Hakuna Mungu Kama Yeye. Common song, especially for those of you who are East Africans like myself. You must have seen this song somewhere. So I'm also doing it in a key that most of you are familiar in, but I'm inserting a lot of chord changes here and there. So you have a practice track somewhere down here, and the practice track has a synth line so that you don't lose the melody as you play the chords. So it has a synth line, a bass line, I think, and a beat. So you'll be able to practice. Just check the links below. So I'll just get right into the lesson. I started with a 5 chord, so maybe start with that chord. So something like C sharp, A flat, B, and then I played something like E flat, F sharp, B flat, and C sharp on my right hand. Okay. Okay. If you don't want it to sound, you know, this chord normally sounds like it's this. It normally almost sounds like it's this. So if you don't want it to sound like that, you can ignore this B flat note on your right hand so that you just have this. Okay? So that you have C sharp, A flat, and B on your left hand. And then you have E flat, F sharp, and C on your right hand. Okay? But if you don't mind, you can still add the B flat. Okay? So that you have E flat, F sharp, B flat, and C sharp. So that's the first chord. So okay, so I just went to the one, yeah. So F sharp, C, A flat, and B flat. Okay. And then on my right hand I have something like, so I have C sharp and B flat, but I'm playing the B flat up from the A flat. And for those who cannot play this chord here, on your left hand, just play this. Because anyway, you still have a bass player, so you might not necessarily need this. So play the F sharp, A flat, and B flat. But if you can play this, the better for you. Okay? F sharp, C sharp, A flat, and B flat. So, and before I get to the one chord, I'm playing this as my melody. The B note, yeah. So then I went to the, from there I went to the 6-2-5-1, yeah. So okay. So you could have that as your 6. So you have E flat, F sharp, and A flat, and then you have B flat, C sharp, and F sharp. Okay, so that's the 6. Then my melody, I played that as my 2. So I have A flat and F sharp on my left hand. And then on my right hand, I simply have a B flat major chord, which is B flat D F. Okay. So and then I went to the 5. So I have C sharp and E, and then I, on my left hand, then I have A flat, B, E flat, and F sharp on my right hand, okay? So you have something like, then 6-2-5, okay? And then I have this as my 1, E flat, no, not E flat, I have E on my left hand, then I have B flat, E flat, and A flat on my right hand, okay? So that one is your one chord. So if you really want to keep the bass line intact, you just play that F sharp and E on your right hand, okay? But since the track kind of has a bass line, you don't need this. Just play that, okay? Play it rootless. So E, B flat, E flat, and A flat, okay? So then that's your four. So you have E flat, then you have A flat, C sharp, and F sharp, okay? Then if you really want to keep your bass line intact, just play that. Okay? So you have B and E flat, then you have A flat, C sharp, and F sharp, okay? So, okay, so that's the four. And then, so it's basically the chord on my right hand that is changing, yeah? So, and then, so you have that, B flat, E flat, left hand, A, C sharp, F on your right hand. That's an A augmented chord, okay? So, then, okay, so on to the three. My three looks like that, B flat, F sharp, then I have A flat, C sharp, and F sharp, okay? Yeah, and then, so that's my six. So I have something like E flat, F sharp, A flat, and B flat on my left hand, okay? Yeah. And then I have C sharp, F, and A flat on my right hand. But I am leading into the F from the E flat, so it sounds like, yeah. So then I went to my two, so you have something like, or maybe you can have something like a, so A flat, F, then you have C sharp, F sharp, and B flat, okay? Or you can have this A flat, F, then B, and then you have C sharp, F sharp, and B flat. Yeah, so you could have something like, okay? That's what how your right hand chord looks like. So you have B, C sharp, F sharp, and B flat, okay? So you start with that as your first chord. Then your second chord looks like this. Okay? So the left hand remains the same. That's A flat, F sharp. So you have then you have that C, F, and A flat. Okay? Leading into the F from the A flat. Okay? So you have this. Or this. Yeah? The third chord looks like that. C, F sharp. So all that you play while you are still on the two. So then, okay. So see that, then to the five, and I'm playing it rootless. So I have F sharp, A flat. Then I have B, E flat, A flat, okay? So that's your five. Okay? Then what you will do, drop the F sharp to the F and drop the E flat to the C sharp. Okay? Yeah? So that's the five or the seven, yeah? So from the beginning, a quick transition, yeah. Then from there I went to a 7-3-6, but I'm kind of leading into the 7 from the 1, so I did something like this. It looks some chord like that, yeah. So that's my one chord. That's how my one chord looks like, yeah. So F sharp, E, A. Then I have C sharp, E, A flat, and B. Okay. Then I'll just drop everything down by a semitone. So that becomes my seven. So I have F, E flat, A flat. Then I have C, E flat, G, and B flat. Okay. That's my 1, 7, and then to the 3. Okay? So my left hand looks like B flat, D, A flat, and then so on my left hand I have B at the bottom and A flat at the top. Then I'm doing something like this from E to F, yeah? Okay? While the B and A flat are still intact, yeah? The one I just showed you, yeah? The 6, I mean. Okay? Still the same thing. E, F sharp, A flat, B flat. Then you start with F, A flat, back to E flat, F, okay? Okay, so then from there I went to the 7. It's something like that. F, E flat, then you have G, B flat, D and F. Then take everything up by a semitone. So you have F sharp, E, then you have A flat, B, E flat and B flat. And as usual, I said if you want to ignore a certain note here, like here you can ignore the D note. You can ignore that. So you just have that here. You don't have to add the D note. And then for the here, you can ignore the E flat. Okay? You can ignore the E flat. So anyway, it's however you choose. So then back to our one, the previous one, E, B flat, E flat, A flat, 4, E flat, A flat, C sharp, and F. So that's your 1, 4. And then to this chord, so that's how my chord looks like. So E flat, F sharp, A flat, and B flat, then I have D, F sharp, B flat, and C sharp. D, F sharp, A flat, B, then D, A flat, B. So that's my next chord. First chord. Then back to your 1/5. So that's F sharp, A flat, B flat. Then I have C sharp, F sharp, and B flat. If you want to add the bass line, just add this note. Yeah. The C sharp, yeah. So okay, so the chord looks like, so F sharp, A flat, and C, and then I'm still doing the same thing I was doing on the 6. F sharp, A flat, down to E flat, F sharp, yeah. Okay, then C sharp, F sharp, A flat, B, E flat, A flat. Then you have that C sharp, F, then B, D, F, B flat. Then just drop the B flat to the A flat, yeah? And finish to the 1. Okay? F sharp, C sharp, A flat, B flat, C sharp, F sharp. So that's the whole song, basically. Okay? So I'll just play through it. So then 6, 2, 5, 1, 4, remain on the 4. Then 3, 6, then to the 2. The 1, the 7, the 3, 6, and then to the 7, to the 1. Okay, then that's still the 1 to the 4, then the flat 7 to the flat 6, then to the 5, okay, then that's the 2, yeah, back to the 1. So basically that's the whole song, okay. If I inserted a few chord changes, probably where did I substitute So maybe then from when you finish here, so then you start again. So you see, in the first round I went straight to the 6-2-5-1. So in the second round I might have added a 3 chord. So that's the 3 chord I added. So D, A flat, then C sharp, F sharp, B flat, yeah? Then you just go to the 6, then to the 2-5-1, then 4, maintain, then 3, then 6, then to the 2, then 1-7-3-6, okay? Then I played a 2 again. Yeah, A flat F, B flat D, F sharp, then 5, the same 5 we played at the beginning, really. Then 1, same thing, yeah. So then, okay, so basically that's the whole song. There are a lot of chord changes, so if you are kind of a beginner, take time to study them very well. Yeah. There are a lot of chord changes. And make sure you are keeping in touch with the melody such that you don't get lost. That's why the practice track has a melody line, okay? So make sure you check the practice track. It's somewhere down here. And then you can also check out our courses on the key of F sharp. We have two. We have an intermediate one and an advanced one. What I was teaching here was kind of advanced. So if you are not that level of player, check the intermediate course first. And then you can advance later. So that was just it for the lesson. Make sure you subscribe and click on the notification button if you haven't, because lessons will be coming your way frequently.
So I hope you enjoyed this lesson. Now, there are just a few things I'd like you to do to help us spread this word and support us. The first thing is to go ahead and hit the like button below this video. Just go ahead and hit the like button. And the second thing you can do is to share this video on our social media platforms, on Facebook, on Twitter. Just go ahead and hit the share button so that it will help us to spread this message so that more people can get access to these lessons. And the third thing is that if you have been watching my lessons and you're not subscribed to my channel, please just go right ahead right now. Log into Google with your Gmail, okay? With your Gmail, your email address, log into YouTube, and then hit the subscribe button so that you'll always be notified when I release new classes. And then the last thing you can do is to visit our website, majestieshouseofmusic.com. Then click on the piano video courses and you'll see a list of several longer detailed courses where I go much deeper into these concepts, okay? So if you visit our website, you can order those courses there online. If you have a PayPal account, if you don't have a PayPal account, you can just send me an email or a WhatsApp message, and then we can communicate on how you can order the courses and how I'll deliver them to you as downloadable files. I'll simply send to you a link and you can download the course that you are interested in. So thank you for following this channel, and God bless you. See you in the next class.